But again, we're going to parse it very, very closely, as will my next guest, market watcher Scott Martin. We've got Greg Belliere and Deirdre Bolton, who is at the Sheraton Hotel in Manhattan, where Jerome Powell will be speaking. Deirdre, the kind of crowd that gathers there, is this a banking crowd? How would you describe it?
So it's bankers, it's economists, and it's people literally, Neil, with a seat at the table. A lot of these people are sources or contacts for Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin, whom our sources tell us has really been working behind the scenes to maybe come up with a plan that affects the same thing, a slowing perhaps, an addressing of inflation worries, but by reducing the balance sheet and perhaps not so overtly raising rates. But, Neil, you mentioned what the speech is about today. Of course, the Fed chairman going to be officially addressing the stability of the financial system. We expect him to talk about asset prices and sort of these four main factors that he is going to be monitoring. But all the focus is going to be on the Q&A, of course, afterwards. And to what extent will the markets move on that information? As you very well know, the Fed funds futures are pricing in a 79% chance of a rate hike in December. But if you look to 2019, right at this moment, interestingly enough, Fed funds futures actually only showing a one rate increase that is certain in 2019. So that is very much below even what the Fed itself has telegraphed. Neil, we do have an advanced copy of Chairman Powell's speech. I just want to put one line up on the screens for our viewers here because it just shows this diplomatic dance that he is trying to do. We know that moving too fast, and of course by that he means raising rates, would risk shortening the expansion. I won't read this whole thing, but he also talks about, on the other hand, we know that there are risks in higher inflation and destabilizing financial imbalances. So he really is walking as tight a rope as possible. We know President Trump has been openly critical of him. You referenced that comment saying that he's not happy, not even a little bit, not blaming anyone, but just telling you, I think the Fed is way off base with what they are doing. So Chairman Powell, of course, walking this very fine line. And Neil, as you can tell from behind me here, clearly a packed house, Neil.
All right. Greg, we always want to get an indication from the Federal Reserve Chairman where he stands on interest rates and hints that in this speech he's going to talk about just being a tad below neutral right now. Markets usually seize on that sort of stuff as saying, all right, maybe one more hike and we can chill for a while. Would you be in that camp?
Oh, I sure would. And I think the one code word to look for, Neil, is headwinds. If he starts to talk about headwinds on trade, stock prices, inflation, global concerns, that's a tip-off that they are going to go slower.
You know, Scott Martin, markets would welcome that. Anything that slows the rate and the pace of increases now, that might be among the reasons why the Dow is sprinting ahead close to 400 points. What's going on?
Yeah, the Dow spiking, Neil. The S&P is up about 15 points since we started this show, so yay us. I'll tell you, I got the pits behind me. And, I mean, the Fed comments that Deirdre revealed there, Neil, are being an electrifier like a hairdryer. I mean, this is going wild because of the fact that you pointed out, which is really, frankly, what we kind of knew all along, because Fed Powell and his crew kind of gave us this indication a couple weeks back about how they realized that investment is slowing. They realized that consumers may be feeling a little bit of a pinch, especially in the housing market. They see the bond market, guys, where rates have started to come down in the last 3 weeks, not gone up. So everything is leading the Fed to take a pause, and they're listening to the market, and that's why the market likes it.
Deirdre, we should just explain, we talk about neutral. A lot of people want to know what would be neutral. I mean, we've been so used to 0% interest rates. This would be the fourth under Mr. Powell's leadership. There were rate hikes under Janet Yellen, his predecessor, but we came from zero to a range of 2 to 2.25% on federal funds, the overnight bank lending rate. That's the rate at which banks lend to each other. And so presumably we're going to lift it within another quarter point range to 2.25%, 2.5% if we're to accept some of this sentiment coming out of his proposed remarks. He seems to be saying that might be the sweet spot. And that is sweet for the markets, should it be?
And if it should it be, if we look at that chart historically, Neil, I mean, we are still at historically low levels, as you just pointed out. I mean, even with these 8 increases since the year 2015, you know, if you look at that chart, what we've seen over generations, we're still pretty low, but there are a lot lot of concerns that even the Fed itself has telegraphed, right? It said it is monitoring asset prices. It is also monitoring corporate borrowing. That seems to be something that we're seeing in a lot of different language. Also monitoring Brexit, monitoring what is going on in Italy, monitoring the trade tensions that we have had between the U.S. and China. So neutral, it's a hard number to find, and I think that's very much a challenge ahead of the Fed.
Well, I know you have to get in there, Deirdre. I very much appreciate it. Our own Charles Payne is seizing on these remarks as well that are scheduled to be made in just a few minutes from the Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell, that interest rates are just below neutral. What that could signal, I say could, because this can change based on economic data or a good or bad day in the stock market, that the pace of increases will start to slow. And maybe, Greg Valliere, part of that is the craziness of the markets. Part of it might just be the fact that some of the economic data has been disappointing. For example, in the housing sector, home sales, new home sales are dropping the most they have in 2.5 years. What do you think's going on and what the Federal Reserve is worried about?
I think they're worried that we're not overheating. We're getting just the opposite. Things are starting to soften. But let me just add, Neil, two notes of caution. Number one, we're still going to get a move in 3 weeks. I'd be surprised if we didn't. Number two, this ongoing friction between the president and Powell, which may intensify if we get a move in 3 weeks, is not healthy. I think it creates more speculation than the markets would prefer to see. Net, 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 this is a very good afternoon.
All right, we shall see. Scott Martin, you know, the president has been a critic of this sort of Pavlovian response of any Federal Reserve when things start humming along, so begin the hikes in interest rates that can kind of dampen it. He is making a point that other presidents have made, just not as publicly or loudly, but will anything that Powell says today be seen through that prism of being jawboned to do the right thing?
I hope not, because I think Powell at the end of the day is doing the right thing. And to clarify something I said earlier, that's right. The December hike is baked in the cake. I'm talking about the pause in 19 now.
Right.
Good for Powell, I guess, Neil, that he's actually pretty tall. I think he's about 5'10 or 5'11. So there's a chance that the president is not going to be as harsh on him if he does start to listen to this market and maybe back off the hawkish tone that he had, you know, back earlier.
Yeah, we should explain. There's a story on the wires. I don't know how accurate it is that he was skeptical of reappointing Janet Yellen because she was short. The White House had not, given that much of a response. It sounds a little silly to me, but. Anyway, that's part of the brilliant musing of Scott Martin here.
Yeah, but
go ahead.
To be fair, he has mentioned other people's physical characteristics, so I'm not surprised. And he would have said that he would have kept Yellen in the position if she was taller. But anyway, Neil, that's neither here nor there. The reality is Powell is doing the right thing, Neil, by listening to the market, watching the bond market, and seeing rates flatten out and drop in the last few weeks as we approach this meeting, just to show that things are softening and they've got to be a little bit more cautious going forward on being so hawkish.
All right. And Greg, just so you know, the president's nickname for me is Loser Neil. It's not. Let's say all of a sudden he does, that is, the Federal Reserve Chairman has a kind of a dovish tone to this, that I had to make these aggressive steps. I mean, you've always reminded me, the years we've known each other, that Federal Reserves under any leadership can overplay their hand or overdo it, either too late to respond to inflation by hiking rates when the damage is done, or too slow to cut them. So they never get exactly right. What do you think the markets are going to look for?
Well, his skills as a communicator, I would argue, Neil, in the last few weeks, people were beginning to wonder if he was communicating very well. I think today's speech is going to remove a lot of those doubts.
Why do you say that? What are you listening for that would kind of calm your nerves?
Because I think he realized something was happening in the markets. He listened to the markets. The markets were trying to tell us something, and he got it.
Do you buy that, Scott?
Not yet. I think we're in the early innings of seeing this as maybe a more dovish or communicative Powell. But I will tell you something. You know, you guys are talking about something interesting earlier with Deirdre about neutral. And I kind of wish I didn't drop my philosophy class back in college, because the reality is it's a philosophical question, right? Like, is today's neutral really our father's neutral or our grandfather's neutral? Like, where is neutral given the fact that we've got this slew of data that's now softening, but we still have some inflation concerns and things like that, heating up job market on wages? So neutral is really that hard thing to pinpoint, which is where the Fed wants to be, to where they can keep rates flat.
Guys, as you're speaking, we're already showing the Dow about 411 points on these comments that are trickling out from the prepared speech that Jerome Powell, the Federal Reserve Chairman, he has been in that capacity since February, hit the wires. And among some of the accommodative, and I always say accommodative in terms of what the market's like to see, that doesn't mean they're right, but that there is apparently going to be a slowdown in rate increases, or that's the perception from the Fed Chairman's remarks. For example, the 10-year has been sliding down to around 3.04 to 3.6%. Yields on two-year notes, another good proxy for how short-term sentiment is building right now, you know, hovering at around the 290 level. Did I get that right, guys? That would be about right. So what are we to make of 280? I apologize. What are we to make of that, Greg Valliere, if all of a sudden now the markets start contending with, wait a minute, if they slow down, you're damned if you do, damned if you don't. What do they see that we don't see? Are they echoing what GM was concerned about in laying off these 15,000 people? Are there bigger concerns here that maybe the markets aren't appreciating? What do you think?
Right. And also, Neil, I'd make this point. What if the next employment number, we're going to get it soon, shows unemployment drops another tenth, that non-farm payrolls look healthy? What if the OPEC gets its act together and raises, cuts production, raises oil prices? So this is very ephemeral. I think for right now, it's a very, very good story. But there are still headwinds, lots and lots of factors that can change in an instant.
All right, guys, we should explain here, and you know this inside and out, but the Federal Reserve only controls these short-term interest rates, like overnight bank lending rate. That's a daily rate, Fed funds. That's one you hear a lot, the discount rate for the best customers. That also is something the Federal Reserve can control. After that, it's the markets and their sentiment of what the Fed is doing or what they deem it's not doing or the signal it's sending. So the shorter-term notes and bonds that really have only the markets control, not set by the Federal Reserve, the yield is going down and the price is going up. And that has a two-year now at around 280, 279. And that has a 10-year note also holding and holding lower on the belief here. As that yield goes down, the price is going up, the sentiment that maybe things are going to cool it for a while.